Hello and welcome back to the Healthcare Uncomplicated YouTube channel. Let me remind you to subscribe below if you haven't so far, and also check all the previous content and our partners and supporters here at the channel. And today gives me great pleasure to introduce Sofia Guerra. She's an investor in healthcare and biotech at Bessemer Venture Partners. Sofia, how are you?
Hi, João. Nice to see you, and thanks for having me.
Brilliant. Thank you for accepting my invite. It's nice to connect with you again. We met in US, just a few weeks back, right?
Yeah, the Vibe Conference in Nashville. Yeah.
And today we are here to discuss investment in digital health. And Sofia, we can kick off by addressing some of the trends. What are some investment trends that you are seeing in digital health?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, look, the past, 3 years, COVID was really a watershed moment for the industry. One, because consumers started to pay attention to their health and how they were accessing that at home. And then folks really scrambling to take care of patients outside of the hospital and maintaining them healthy. I think over the last year, we've seen kind of a decline in investment compared to the peak of 2021, but we're still seeing kind of a lot of interest in the industry. And a couple of the areas that are kind of very in focus today, there's a lot of talk around PBMs and drug pricing, given some of the legislation discussions that are going on in Congress. So a lot of interest in the specialty pharmacy channel, just like very expensive drugs, and how do we get those to patients when they need them and are able to afford them. Also a huge trend in kind of this shift in kind of technology opportunity with artificial intelligence. And there's a wide range of types of models we can use, from ML to AI, and advancements in large language models, and a discussion of how we can apply those technological shifts to healthcare. It can be on the administrative workflows, payments, all the way to clinical care. And there's a lot of interest in really understanding where we can apply those improvements. And then on the digital health kind of care delivery side, I think we continue to be very excited about value-based care opportunities, especially in those like really high cost need areas, like maternal health, oncology, cardiology, and the such.
Brilliant, Sofia. Thank you so much. You know, it's the big buzz. It's been for a while the hype around artificial intelligence and other things, but things are progressing. Thanks for highlighting the other items around value-based healthcare and also the healthcare outside the hospital. Things are and the biotech, which you specialize in with the pharma angle. Moving on, what is important when it comes to investment?
No, I think we, number one, first and foremost, I think in healthcare, understanding like the outcomes, not just financial kind of return on investment for your customer, but also kind of clinical outcomes are kind of very table stakes. I think especially in this environment where customers are asking more questions on, hey, what's the benefit to my organization from contracting with you, digital health company? And then on the financial and operational side, we've been studying how companies in the health tech space have scaled over time. And while some KPIs and financial metrics are very similar across healthcare SaaS and tech-enabled services, I think there is an emphasis that not just top-line growth matters, but also the unit economics underlying that. And by that, I mean, what are your gross margins and your ability to kind of turn a revenue dollar that comes through the door into gross profit, as well as the operating, how much you're spending in sales and marketing, for example, to bring more revenue in the door. So that efficiency of those businesses has been kind of high area of focus for a lot of investors, managing burn. Like, look, high growth venture-backed companies, we're not expecting you to be profitable from the beginning. There's like always a trade-off and a balance between how much you grow and what you're burning. But then we're putting a lot of emphasis on kind of efficiency And especially for digital health, the last year or bucket metric that we pay a lot of attention to is the recurrency of the top line, because clinical delivery doesn't necessarily mean recurring. Let's scrap that off the table. But there are instances where there is recurring revenue, or perhaps you have a contract and perhaps you're not engaging the same patient year over year, but that contract is stable in terms of the revenue you get, and you can grow the engagement with that customer, especially for B2B to C businesses. So thinking about kind of how do you track kind of cohorts in which you're seeing how spend is changing over time for your customers in a given year is very important.
Oh, brilliant. Thank you, Sofia. So a great emphasis there on efficiencies and also the strongest business, the business operational side. And the, moving on to the third and last item, I would like you to give us a bit of an overview where and how the industry is evolving. I know we mentioned the trends in the first question, and I actually was reading an article today that for the first time in Q1 of 2023, the investment in digital health slowed down. Even with the pandemic that you mentioned, it was an increase in high demand, and it's a very exciting industry, very competitive, but also very exciting. But any other things that you'd like to mention about the state of industry overall?
Yeah, absolutely. Look, like COVID was a great moment for the industry to kind of be at front and center of consumers and businesses' minds. I think we're going to go back to levels like pre-COVID, but I think the genie is out of the bottle. Like, we all understand that technology really needs to impact the way we deliver care. The trends in growing costs and bad outcomes are not sustainable. So technology really is a way in which we can change that those trends. And I'm a big believer that entrepreneurship really is a way of really building businesses from the ground up that can challenge the status quo, because the status quo is what got us where we are. If you look at, back 10 years ago, levels of investing in digital health were below $1 billion. We are way past that and up and to the right. So I think that investment is going to continue in the space, perhaps, and certainly not at the rate of 2021. But there are lots of great companies out there that are at scale, that are great businesses. And let's hope that we can focus on supporting those businesses to be successful. Perhaps there were some that went public that weren't the most efficient businesses, or perhaps there's a need for kind of the public market and private market investors to really understand more about these businesses and see more examples. So then support for early stage companies in those bucket categories kind of continues to grow. But I think that I'm bullish in the market. I'm bullish that there's a lot of need that we need to leverage technology and entrepreneurship to solve big problems in the space.
No, brilliant. There are certainly, Sofia, as you well know, a lot of deep, complex issues, and the healthcare is very complicated, but there are lots of things to solve. So it's great that the innovation is still going, a lot of exciting companies appearing all the time. As I mentioned before, it's a competitive space, but every industry is competitive in these days. It's not like 20 years ago that you got half a dozen of competitors. It's very, very different nowadays. Sofia, I want to thank you in advance for your time, for your expertise, for this magnificent conversation. I have one last little thing, which is the surprise question, is before I round up, is how can we make healthcare uncomplicated?
Uncomplicated.
Yeah.
I think we can start very small, like things like what you're doing, right? Of how do we educate and have conversations on how the different stakeholders interact, and really what are the incentives that are set up at kind of our understanding to like build better businesses that really align those stakeholder incentives. That's at the very small scale. I think legislation is the way that we really change healthcare. We always keep an eye on big changes that are happening on the legislative side to really think about, okay, what is this pushing for increased technology adoption? Because technology is really going to change and uncomplicate healthcare. I'm a believer of that. also, how is legislation or shifts in kind of consumer sentiment changing? Because if the consumer is at the center of their health, we believe that you can make better choices in the long term and kind of drive down cost of care. And then, yeah, this alignment of incentives and how do we think about value-based care? And value-based care has been a buzz, and I think there's a lot of criticism around it. Like, can it actually change? And I think there is a whole gamut of how you can take risk and how we provide value for the care that we're receiving or giving. But those are kind of the things that we think about.
Brilliant. Sophia, that's a great way to round up. I like what you mentioned at the beginning about educating the audience and bringing the stakeholders together. That was my vision with this YouTube channel, this amazing platform, to bring everyone together, from public health to private companies, big tech brands that I had on the channel, investors like yourself, innovators, startups. So I really wanted patients. I had patient advocates in here. And yeah, brilliant. I like that. Sophia, thank you so much again for your magnificent insights and everything. And I'm going to round up.
Thank you, João. I appreciate it.
Right. To all our viewers and listeners, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, I'm going to post Sophia's LinkedIn and socials in here. Make sure you come back to her, ask her any questions around her expertise or around anything else. And make sure you connect with our partners, and I'll see you all next time.